I want to first of all thank you. It was a very clear demonstration. You showed a need, how you wanted to approach it, and what I liked is you had a crisp demo at the end that really brought it home. This is just an impression here. I see that you've really done two things. One, you created what I want to call a rapid risk assessment, which is one piece, and then what you do with that is insurance. Mm-hmm. It's purely an aside, and I know you need to stay focused, but if you really have rapidly solved that risk assessment of a third party, that is very valuable in itself, and I just want to bring home what Catherine Donald said earlier. That's something many organizations are interested in, so I would recommend just keeping an ear towards that. And if you really have solved that, I think you have many more potential uses for what you figured out.
And that's what I mean, it's the perennial, do you want to sell shovels or do you want to build a new one? And the way we felt about this was is that insurance is one of the most horrible experiences on the planet, particularly for small businesses. And this is a valuable tool. I'm sure I can find a way to sell some insurance companies. I don't have a lot. It doesn't get me excited more to make an insurance company a little bit more powerful, slightly improve the combined ratio, limit their losses, etc. Because I don't really believe in the trickle-down economics of that, but helping them with that is really going to transform into this product, showing up their investment. And that's why we want to be this MGA, this managing type of agency, because we saw the system in need, we saw it in Rackspace, we saw the jungle list, we've seen it with a lot of people who've gone out interview and survey, and that's the one we want to go fix right now. But to your point, it's a pretty nice backup plan that if all things go, you know, go to hell, a pivot to go and sell the insurance company could find a backup.
Yeah, I just had a question about the model itself. And so it's an agency model, right? So you're not taking on any of the risk. Mm-hmm. So ultimately, you're making the user experience better. Correct. At the end of the day, though, the differentiating factors I didn't quite understand, because if you create an insurance policy, then arguably the carriers are the ones that actually have to create the policy and underwrite the risk, right? Unless you're going to take on risk.
No, so we're following this MGA model. Okay. Agencies. So for that, we're taking quite a bit of commission because okay. It's our underwriting model, our data.
And that's where I have a question. So from this is where I thought you could make it clear. If I'm putting myself in the shoes of the customers, and if, when I buy my own insurance, I'm always thinking, okay, this is cheaper, right? Or this is better service. This is much easier to. And having just taking a insurance agency public last year, you know, the key thing is the ability to look and say, okay, the ability to pay. Right, and that's what I know. We only had 5 minutes. That was where it didn't come across to me as clearly as I would have hoped in terms of in the eyes of the customers. Okay, I'll pay $49 a month, but at the end of the day, what show me your worthiness that you will pay me better than if I insure directly with AIG, let's say.
Sure. And so who we're partnering for our paper and for the reinsurance, I'm not going to name them because it's the final terms of the MGA negotiation. But they are, you know, a tier one reinsurer, that is obviously A-rated by AMS and all that kind of stuff. Okay. So they're also a name that is pretty well known in specialty insurance.
And then, so the technological capabilities, totally clear, and I get the value proposition and why you'd be valuable to, you know, the carriers was definitely clear, and why you could make a viable business model was just from an underwriting standpoint, making sure I understood that.
And it's really, when we spoke to, because one of our big things was finding that provider, person who's basically that reinsurer who's going to basically reinsure insurance. Because we're a startup, you know, we don't have the capital to become an insurance carrier on day one. And one of the things there is, in the world of cyber insurance, you hear this all the time, there are no actual tables, right? And then tables are like, where were these claims, what's the frequency, how bad is the risk there? So we built our own. So by collecting this content data,
Sorry, we got two more companies.
I will follow up with you after.
Sorry, babe, we got to stop you there.